Radishes.
Nice. Woo. Very good, Ian boy. Very good. Give us a little Devil Went Down to Georgia. Very good, Ian boy. I like that. What's the name of this game called?
Muckers.
Muckers.
Or Muckluck for short. It's
supposed to be kind of, I guess, like horseshoes. And there's $4 riding on this, the first person to get a ringer.
If you hit the bird, you get 10.
This is like the only game that you play in the yard where the score constantly remains at zero.
Sponsored by Mountain Dew.
Oh, shit.
Oh.
Damn.
Ian Boy's probably going to be the one to get the $4. He's throwing them closer and more consistently than I am.
Yeah, you suck at throwing.
Throw a baseball at your head right quick.
Oh, sure.
That's a fire.
That's a muckler.
Okay, here we are a few minutes later. Still no ringer from anybody. So what have we determined about this game?
It's hard.
Ian boy, what have we determined about this game? Sucks. We're getting real close, but...
No cigar. I'm sure if we had a bunch of those pegs over here, you could hit one.
On!
Captain Rotten Sox just hit the ringer. There it is. And Ian Boy is going off his rocker.
Damn it!
I'm gonna split it with him.
Captain Rotten Sox.
Yeah. Today is your lucky day. You've tripped over the goddamn cat and fell down the stairs of life. You found the Captain Rotten Sox and Ian Boy Show. Brought to you by your pals at Brighto. 999,000 bottles sold.
We are Geico Insurance. For years, you have depended on us and our extra 1 or 2% savings in your car insurance, and we've been proud of that. But today we are now also proud sponsors of Dr. Ernest Bright and his delicious Brighto. Brighto, Brighto, it makes old bodies new. But kids want to know, what does it really do?
Yeah, I guess we do kind of wonder.
What is the stuff anyways?
Abby, smell it, come on, do it.
Ew, it smells like stain remover.
Hey, look over there. Isn't that the Geico guy?
Switching to Geico, really? How does that go? Could switching to Geico really, save something? Oh.
His shirt looks terrible.
Well, if this is sand remover, I bet it'll fix that shirt.
Well, why don't you go over there and see if it works, Shane?
Hey, Mr. Geico man, what are you doing?
Oh, hello. Well, I'm doing rehearsing for the commercials. As you see, I'm wearing my beautiful lucky shirt.
Yeah, well, I couldn't help but notice that your lucky shirt has a couple of stains.
Oh, maybe that's why my rehearsal isn't going so good, you know? I've been rehearsing in this shirt for many years. Can't rehearse without it. Commercials don't come out good unless I rehearse in this shirt. What do you have there, son?
Well, this is Brighto, sir. It'll knock that stain right out of your shirt, guaranteed.
Well, maybe that's why my rehearsals haven't been going so good lately. Can't have a stain on my lucky shirt. You think that'll work? Give it a shot. Oh man, I can't wait. I hate having stains. Ah, that's good. That hits the spot. You know, I got this shirt in Hawaii, 1945. I'm not really as young as I look, but I was there, you know, and ooh, it kind of tingles my arm a little bit. Is this really how that's supposed to work? It does tingle. Hey, is that stain gone?
Yeah, the stain's gone. Yeah, the stain's gone, and so am I.
Why did he run off so quick? What the hell? Hey, you, get back here!
Come on, kid, we gotta split.
Wow, that guy was fast.
Yeah, I'll say.
Hey, wait a minute, this isn't bringing up old bodies.
Yeah, maybe like car bodies. This isn't standing mover, it's car polish.
Hey Shane, let's go polish Dad's car with this stuff.
Yeah, he'll be pretty surprised.
Shane, is this doing what I think it's doing?
Yeah, it's taking the paint off the car. Grab the bottles and run!
Hey! What are you doing to my car? Get back here!
Hey Shane, I just figured out what Fredo's good for.
Getting us in trouble?
Yeah, that's right.
Hey, Abby, listen up. It says it's manufactured by Bright's Medical Company.
So we have been using this long all along? It's medicine?
You know, we've come so far already. I just gotta find out what this does.
I agree.
You know, we need somebody to try this on.
Yeah, someone who always needs medicine.
Someone who's always complaining they don't feel good.
Someone who always says he's in a lot of pain.
Yeah. Someone who's always willing to try any sort of drug or medicine without knowing the side effects. Yeah, we know.
Don Gato!
Oh boy. I'm not feeling too good today. It's tough when you're Don Gato. Too many parties. Too many random kittens. Oh. Not to mention all those stunts for those Geico commercials. They're really eating me up.
Hey, Don Gato. Huh? You look like total crap.
Yeah, geez, thanks for noticing. Those Geico commercials are really tearing me up. I'm on live number 8 or 7 or something like that. You know, we only have 9 lives.
Well, me and Shane have something that'll make you feel a lot better.
Huh? Say hello to Brighto.
Oh, no, you don't. I'm not gonna try any random medicine from you guys. Every time you do something, you get me hurt, or injured, or killed, or burned, or exploded, drowned, frozen, electrocuted. I'm not playing these games with you guys anymore.
Oh, stubborn patient, eh?
Uh-huh.
Hey, Abby.
What?
Give him a little anesthetic.
You get away from me! Ah!
Here, drink this, cat.
Oh, what did you guys pour into me? Ah! Oh God, it tastes terrible! What did you do to me? Oh, I don't feel so good. Oh. What's happening to me here? Whoa! Thank you guys so much. I'm so sorry I doubted you. You guys did a wonderful job. I feel great. Oh, yes, and thank you, Dr. Bright, and your delicious Brighto. Well, delicious. Actually, it kind of tastes a little bit like car polish or like a stain remover or something. Something.
Brighto, makes old bodies new. We'll sell a million bottles.
Hi, I'm Captain Rotten Socks.
And I'm your co-host, Amy.
And welcome to our dry ice extravaganza.
Part deux.
So today, we're going to be exploring some of the experiments we're going to do with dry ice. Well, that we're gonna do. That you probably shouldn't.
But we're gonna do it anyway.
So today we're coming to you from an outdoor studio for convenient purposes. God, things could get messy.
No, they will get messy.
So this is what 100 pounds of dry ice looks like. So each one of these blocks will weigh
50 pounds.
50 pounds. How are we ever gonna get it out of there? It's easy, you just lift it up. There they are. Beauties. Real beauties. I'm sublimating.
Now we know that dry ice is simply carbon dioxide in solid form. Carbon dioxide goes from a solid to a gas. There is no in-between in this atmosphere. In our atmosphere, carbon dioxide cannot be a liquid. It converts to a gas through a process known as sublimation, which essentially means melting.
So the one thing that you might think of does look like regular ice, but it's not. In fact, if you touch it for too long, you'll get a frostbite. If I touch it right now, nothing.
But if you hold your finger on there, it'll freeze
you'll,
the skin cells.
You'll burn. It's gonna hurt. So don't.
Frostbite.
So if you're gonna try, if you're gonna do this, make sure you wear gloves.
Right. Where's your gloves?
Now everybody knows that if you take dry ice and a warm bucket of water, you put it in, it makes vapor like the haunted house effects.
Yeah.
Now we're gonna do something different. Something that we've never done before.
We're gonna make a geyser. So what we did here is fill this 2-liter bottle with warm water and poked a hole in the cap.
Now,
all we need to do is break the dry ice up and put it in the bottle.
And we should have a geyser. We don't know because we've never done it before. Okay, so when you take the cap off.
Icebergs.
This table's not that desperate.
Those little
dry ice pebulets. Pebulets.
What?
Okay, Ian boy.
A little dry ass pebulet got me.
Pebulets.
Alright.
Okay, put some dry ice in there.
Pebulet.
I didn't get burned, I just...
A little pebulet.
I didn't get burned, I just didn't want to take the risk.
No, pick it up quick and put it on the table.
We need gloves because this stuff is...
No joke.
Yeah, I think a little piece of it got burned in my hand.
Okay, so now I'm gonna put the cap on and see what happens. Hopefully it won't explode.
Pebulets.
It's not geysering.
Because we haven't turned it upside down.
Yeah, that's the key.
Ah, he has to sit there.
He's geysering.
Well, you made it work.
Well, if you want to water your garden,
and this is the way to do it.
It's exceptional. It's superlative.
Is it getting,
It's gaining a little bit of pressure, but nothing that's going to make it explode.
Until it does.
No, I don't think so. Each time the water goes over there to the cap, it's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Okay, we've just reloaded it.
You can feel the pressure really build up when you turn it upside down.
But it is leaking, so it won't explode theoretically. Happy little sublimating.
There is some serious pressure going on in there. Happy little freeze.
So it makes a little geyser.
So the one side effect, if you put dry ice in water, it'll carbonate it just like soda.
You can see there's little tiny carbonation bubbles in there. And Captain Rotten Sog's just making noise with the...
And I'm making noise too. And don't forget to click on the logo. Buy some now. Get it now.
And this turns into like essentially soda water. Game Boy likes breaking the ice again for the chicks. Hey, Game Boy, you got some good chunks. This is our, well, dry ice. Noisemaker. Alright, Ian boy, load her up. Better than fireworks. Oh man.
Come on now.
It is bulging like crazy.
Have you ever wanted a popsicle like any flavor?
We're gonna show you how to make them right now. First, take the popsicle sticks.
Get a block of dry ice and melt a indent for the popsicle to freeze up in there. So the flavor I'm gonna be making for my popsicle is Mountain Dew Pitch Black. And once again, don't forget, just double checking. So the first thing we're gonna be doing is pouring the liquid in the indent we got right here. And next, we add the stick.
The popsicle stick. You have to hold it down too.
You just have to hold it for a few minutes.
See what happens.
What do you think is going to happen?
It's going to freeze up, and that's where we got our popsicle.
Now, scientifically, how does this happen?
Well, the dry ice is so cold that it freezes almost instantly. But for all this stuff to freeze, it's going to take a few minutes.
Yeah. It smells good.
Yeah. It smells like Mountain Dew.
Seems to be some police activity in town.
Now it's gonna be a fizzy popsicle.
Will it be a fizzy popsicle? That's interesting. I never considered that.
So, when the liquid starts to freeze a bit, you can be able to let go, and it'll stay by itself.
Ow! What happened, Captain Rotten Socks? You got hurt on a popsicle stick?
Splinter.
Walk it off.
Seems to be freezing up nicely.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And the freezing continues. And this dry ice, with the wind, you can see it's sublimating like crazy. Bit left.
Now, as you can see, it's pretty frozen all the way through, so it should be safe to remove.
Let's grind out. Wiggle it a little bit. Twist it a little bit.
There we go.
Nice.
Mountain Dew popsicle.
But do you want to eat it yet?
No, because it looks like there's like still bits of like dry ice.
Exactly. Just turn it around. So what do we do?
Just put it in warm water.
That's right. You can't eat it yet because
it is the temperature of dry ice.
Yeah.
So you have to warm it up a little bit. It looks like Barney's tongue.
It's made with Barney tongue.
Okay, Ian boy.
10 out of 10.
Nice.
All right, Captain Rotten Socks, you're up. Look at that.
Flavor I'm using is Mountain Dew Code Red, my favorite.
Nice. Okay, the pour.
Should be good enough.
Yeah, give it some more. Fill her up. Fill her up. Nice and...
That's why we did that outside, right?
That's right. Okay. That looks really cool.
I love how like if you get any on top of the dry ice, it'll like...
Just rolls off.
Yeah.
All right, put your stick in there. Hold it down for a few until it starts to freeze. And we'll see what happens. We're making another indentation in this block with this Mountain Dew can while we wait.
That bee just flying in my can. Only one way to find out.
Yeah, boy, so is that
a good quality popsicle?
Yeah.
It only took about 10 minutes. Very nice.
And 2 seconds to eat. So it's mostly worth it.
It is worth it. It's fun. It's scientific. It's creative.
Yeah.
Does it taste like it's fizzy?
No.
All the fizz went out of it.
It's
So also, I should point out that we took an awful lot of time making this channel in here for this popsicle. However, we figured out that if we took a can of Mountain Dew or any other kind of thing
and
at room temperature.
Under some hot water, you know.
It'll make a channel really quick. It'll make a, what did you call it?
An indent, yeah. Indent really fast.
Nice. Science.
Instead of just using the spoon, because that'll take like 20 minutes.
Yeah, and a lot of freezer burn on your fingers if you're not wearing gloves, right? Mm.
Yeah. True.
On socks, it looks like yours is finished.
Done.
Just about. You know, wiggle it.
Or left and right a bit.
Yeah, you gotta kind of like go around in a little circle or something.
Yeah. Don't just keep pulling up because I'll break it.
That's pretty damn good.
It's your popsicle.
It is fizzy.
Is it fizzy?
It is fizzy.
Nice.
So that's probably because you just opened it before you poured it in.
Yeah.
So, like, popsicles are awesome and everything.
But we got something else.
So, what we got here is melted ice cream.
Melted what kind of ice cream?
Orange.
Sorry not to cough. Amboy was a little ill last week and he's got some residuals going on.
That's 10 out of 10 on the popsicle scale.
Nice. Now, Amboy, what flavor is this?
Orange.
Orange cream, right?
I think that's...
We're going to try making ice cream bars.
Well, that one we poured a little too much in. And this one is perfect because it's a bigger area.
Mm. It's going to take a while to freeze with this one anyway.
That one, Dean boys. He claimed it already.
I think it'll be good.
Mm.
Mm. Yeah.
Might not look like much, but it'll be good.
Yeah.
It's science.
Yeah. And while we're waiting, we can make a dry ice bucket rocket.
I saw it on TV once. Let's try it.
Ian, come on. Back here. Well, the rocket didn't go anywhere. The bottle did.
Didn't go anywhere either.
Should we try it with the 2-liter?
Not here. The cop.
Yeah, boy.
You don't want to go to jail, do you?
Nah.
Just all blame it on Ian Boy.
Yeah, we found him out here with all this. Here are the remnants of the bottle.
still dry ice in the yard. Ian boy, you have anything to say?
Is that loud?
Loud. So now that our ice cream bars are ready, you could pull them out.
Man, those things are hard as a rock. They're not much to look at, man, but there's a whole lot of ice cream bar there. Not yet.
Right.
Right. You can dip yours into that one.
Man, those things are hard as a rock. That's good, Ian boy.
Alright.
Oh. Ah, it's a fly in mine.
It's a little fly cream.
Protein.
Well, scrape it off with your like fingernail or something, or whatever you got handy.
It's frozen in there. There we go.
This doesn't happen to Crazy Russian Hacker.
It's good.
Oh yeah.
Let's make some more ice cream bars. The other batch going in. They're not much to look at, man, but they sure are good.
Really good.
No two like them in the world, that's for sure.
Yeah, that's a 25 out of 10 for me. This is so really delicious.
100 out of 10.
Nice. Very nice. This
needs to go in the water for a little longer.
Our bucket rocket didn't work, and the chocolate chips turned to dust, but this is working out pretty good. The type of ice cream we're using is Friendly's Orange Cream something or other.
It's orange. I think it's just orange cream.
And it was just way easier than
making our own ice cream.
Oh, yeah.
We have some chocolate. Chocolat. What goes better on an ice cream bar
than chocolate? Here we have Ian Boy.
Orange.
Smells dear. Hard to make a new one.
Oh, it's still.
We have our one with chocolate. Starting to freeze the chocolate already.
We'd probably just get away with putting that in the freezer.
Look at that. And now, here for your dancing pleasure, the Captain Rotten Socks and Ian Boy Disco Kitchen.